Hi everyone, so today I'm going to be making my own DIY plate. So basically this plate, you can store any jewelry or anything you want. I'm going to be using these cutters and stuff. I'm going to be using just a little bit of water. The water will help to smooth the clay. And it's just a little bit in a cup that I can reach. I'm going to be using air dry clay, modeling clay, some people call it, or polymer clay. I found this at the Dollar Tree. You can get your own pack and you can choose any color. I chose a red. If I don't want the red, I can always paint it over. And you're going to be needing a small plate, enough that will fit your polymer clay or air dry clay. So let's get started. Okay, so for this, I'm going to be using the air dry clay. I'm going to cut open the packet. Once you're done, you want to put it to dry for whatever it says on the packet. So on my packet, it says allow 24 hours to dry. Some people say 24 to 40 hours. That's like 2 days. But because mine's a dollar store one, it's going to dry up pretty quickly. So I have to make it quick. And also one more thing, if you're going to be making it, make it in a room that is warm. If you make it in a room that has an AC on, a fan, it's more likely to dry quickly. So I have a fan on, so I'm afraid that's going to dry quickly. There's some in the packet. I'll get that later. Scrap it out. So this is what it looks like. Mine came in a little container. It's like little patterns. I can use this on my plate if I want. I don't know if it's enough to fit my entire plate. You don't need it to fit your entire plate, but so here it is. I'm just gonna take it out. Okay, so I turned off the fan, but it also turned off the light. So I have my lamp light on. It's not that much. Okay, so sorry if you guys can't see. This is the polymer clay right now. I have to take it out and I have to mold it. I'm trying to use all of it. If there's some left, that's good. I'm going to use my X-Acto knife. You can use your scissors or whatever to help it get out if you have the same one as me. If you have the same one as me, you know it's pretty sticky. So I just took it from the corners, scraped it out. It's kind of like gum. It's sticky and stretchy. Super sticky. Oh. And it just kind of feels weird when you squish it and the sound. Hear that sound? Okay. So, and I molded it. This is what it actually looked like. Okay, so I have it all taken out of the container now. See? And there's some still left in there. I can take that out later. I'm going to mold it now. Just keep playing with it. Get it warm. Because mine is sticky, it's important that you have something underneath your desk or table. I'm going to show you how it sticks. Okay. See, it kind of leaves a pink stain there and all that. You can always, I have a special thing underneath to protect my desk. Just clean it up. Make sure that the area you are using is clean. Okay. So I knuckled it down, so I'm pretty sure it's ready now. Clump it up into a ball. You can go like this and roll it. So it's kind of smooth now. It's smooth here. I'm gonna put it down. I'm going to use my rolling pin and I'm going to roll it down. And try to keep these out of the way. Okay. It's gonna pat that down. If there's anything dirty, you can just take that up. So now, this is what it looks like. It's super smooth. I like it. And it's thick. We want to make it a little bit thin, not too much. Just a little bit. Try not to make it stick. I'm going to roll it just around and around until it gets to a circle shape. I don't want to make it too thin. Once it's big enough, you want to see if it fits your plate that you're using. So here's my plate. I don't know if you can see that. So still, it's pretty small. It could get a little bit bigger. You can go like this and it will a little bit get bigger. Okay, so I think I just need a little bit more here. Then I'm ready. I'm using my arm to kind of roll it down. Remember, don't make it too thin. Okay. It's almost perfect. It needs to just come off from there. Oops. And with a big push, I'm going to push the plate down and I'm using my X-Acto knife to cut around here. If you have one of these, plastic knife, you can use that too. But I find that the X-Acto knife works much better. Keep doing this around lots of times. Just clean the edges of the plate, because you're going to be needing it later on. Okay. Here it is. Okay, so I'm gonna check to see how big this is. I actually don't need it that big, so with my X-Acto knife, I'm going to cut it like a smaller shape. And if you want to make your side smoother, you can use water, and that will work too. Okay, almost off. So this is how much I actually didn't even need. How much I needed. With the water now, I'm going to slowly start to fix it. I'm going to use a plate as my base. So if you don't know what to do with the water, I'll teach you. So let me just put remaining back into the packet. And I'm going to use a little bit of water on my hand. It's just enough. And just smooth it. It's already starting to get lots better. Here's how it looks. Compare this to all of that. A little bit better. Keep doing that until your sides are fixed. Don't add too much water or else it'll turn into a weird glop. I'm going around once with a wet finger and just smooths it out. Then you can smooth it back into shape. With my thumb, I'm pressing it down, and with my pointer finger, I'm applying the water. Okay. It's actually lots better. Now I'm going to start the designs. Now I'm going to make 9 types of lines, because I'm going to be making a flower one. For this, I'm going to use the plastic knife. So with a pen or pencil, you can first go over where you want the lines to be. Make sure that they are placed out evenly. They aren't, start again. If 9 can't fit onto yours, you can try and do 8. That's how much I'm doing. Make sure you cut yours really good. Start to make a flower shape for the dish. You can go outline it with the knife. Once you're ready, you can use those outlines and start to make your cuts. I'm going to use my X-Acto knife. This is an amazing present that you can use for gifts, for birthdays, for any type of day, or you can just make this fun. You can use the remaining clay left to make different shapes and add it in, like hearts, stars. This is what it looks like now. Take out the pieces. You can again use water and smooth it out. You should make deep cuts so then it's easier to take it off. You can leave this as a design as it will still look very nice. Very slowly remove it from the table. And this is what you have so far. I'm going to take off these pieces and put it into the plate for 24 hours. I'm going to make some designs in the plate. Using water, I'm going to shape it. Looks really nice already. I'm gonna go ahead and put the rest in a container so it doesn't get hard. So now everything is shaped out. On screen it doesn't really look like a heart, I mean a flower, but it actually is pretty cool. I'm going to shape the corners and everything because we are kind of circly. You can use your nail to do that. So here is the flower. You can smooth it out with the water because mine kind of looks kind of rough. You can smooth it out with some water. Now it's ready, everything is smoothed out, the flower is there. You're going to want to put it inside the same plate that you used. And just put it in. Now that it's smaller, I don't think this plate will work. I can use a bowl and I'll put that in there. So here's what it looks like now. I shaped it to the bottom of the bowl so it curves a little bit. The rest of the Play-Doh for different shapes. Use the knife to cut it. Just pull it off. You can make different shapes with it. I'm not really sure what I want to make, so I'm gonna leave that. Okay, so you can do more shapes. More shapes here. I'm gonna do the owl, it's my favorite. I press super hard. So here it is. It's kind of hard to pull it out with air dry clay. Oh, the face got squished. Let's try that again. And more clay. There's some on the ground. I might add a little bit of nice dots in there. It's already starting to dry, so I want to stick whatever I want on now. So it looks like with the dots. anything else that maybe I want?
No.
I'll put the rest in there. Use this. Press super hard. That easily come off. Now it's a hard part to actually take it out. There's the owl. It's not that bad, actually. So I'm going to add it to the middle, to stick it on because now the plate's kind of dry. I'm going to use some water. I'm going to put it to the sides. That way it'll stick on and it won't come off. I'm going to use the plastic knife. Kind of like glue. And there you have it. Leave it to dry for minus for 24 hours, and then we'll see what happens. We'll be right back.